The semantic segmentation tool can be used in cases where pixel-level context is important. For example, semantic segmentation can be used in training autonomous car models to understand the environment in which they drive. Begin by going into the annotation studio from one of your assignments. The brush is the main semantic segmentation tool. If you do not see it, contact your manager and verify that the semantic segmentation tool was added to the task's recipe. Click on the brush tool or a label with the brush tool to select it. Once you click on the brush tool, you will see a set of semantic segmentation subtools appear at the bottom of the annotation tool panel. Adjust the brush stroke size to suit your needs. A thin stroke size to annotate fine details, and a thicker stroke size to quickly annotate larger areas. Stroke width can also be adjusted by holding the Alt key and moving the mouse wheel. To draw, click and hold the left mouse button and move the mouse in the direction you wish to draw. While hovering over the image, use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Adjust the active opacity to see the segmentation more clearly against the background. Then use the bucket tool to quickly paint an entire bounded area. Select the bucket tool by clicking on it, or use the shortcut Shift B, and click anywhere in the target section of the image. Be aware that the bucket can be used only within closed outlined areas, otherwise it will paint the entire image. If you need to make corrections, use the eraser tool in bucket or brush mode. Select the eraser by clicking it or pressing Shift E. To draw straight, vertical, or horizontal lines, press and hold the Shift key as you draw. Another semantic segmentation subtool is the Auto Segmentation tool. The Auto Segmentation tool uses a machine learning algorithm to accelerate semantic segmentation tasks. Draw a box around the object you wish to segment by clicking and holding the left mouse button and moving the mouse. Release the mouse button to finish drawing the box and get an initial segmentation of the object detected inside the box. To make changes to the initial segmentation, click once on an area with no segmentation to have it added to the initial results. Or click once on a segmented area to have it removed. Repeat the process until you are satisfied with the segmentation. Click the check mark to accept the segmentation, or click X to undo it entirely. While opacity for all annotations can be adjusted from the settings, the opacity of semantic segmentation annotations can also be adjusted for an active label, as well as for non-active labels. Making semantic segmentation annotations clearly visible when placed together with other annotations. The Polygon to Mask and Mask to Polygon tools allow you to convert a polygon to semantic segmentation. And vice versa. Use these tools to make your annotation work more convenient. These tools need to be enabled by your manager before you can start using them. Start by selecting the Polygon tool and use it to create a polygon annotation. Click the left mouse button to create polygon dots. Or hold the left mouse button for freehand drawing. Finally, hit Enter to close the polygon. Select one or more polygon annotations. Click the three-dot icon located above the annotation list and select Convert to Mask from the drop-down menu. Convert one or more selected segmentation annotations to polygon using Convert to Polygon. If a manager enabled the enforcement of 100% segmentation annotation from the task recipe, you will need to ensure that all of the pixels in the item are segmented. If there are unsegmented pixels, you will not be able to set the item to status completed. Data Loop provides you with a tool to check your segmentation and help find unmasked pixels. Use the Unmasked Pixels tool to highlight unmasked pixels until you reach 100% of the item. For the most up-to-date information about semantic segmentation and other annotation tools, visit the Data Loop documentation and YouTube tutorial channel.